Okay, so we will start the lecture. Today we are going to discuss some problems or numericals based on our distribution factor and pitch factor. Okay, and that is the three-phase armature windings. So there are some problems or numericals based on KP and KD, distribution factor and pitch factor. So first numerical is that I just dictate you, and at the same time we will try to solve this numerical. The stator winding of synchronous machine has 48 slots. A 4-pole 3-phase winding is made on the stator. Each coil span is 11th slot pitch. Calculate the pitch factor. So there are how many slots are there? So the total slot is equal to 48, and pitch is such that the coil is placed at 11th slot. Okay. So first of all, what we will do? We will calculate the slot angle alpha is equal to 360 divided by 48, which is equal to 7.5 degree mechanical. So now we will convert into the electrical angle. So P by 2 into mechanical angle is equal to, so it is 4 by 2 multiplied by 7.5. So it is a 15 degree electrical. So now it is clear. Now it is given that the slot is placed, the angle, the conductor is placed at slot number 1 and slot number 11. So what would be the number of slots per pole? So number of slots per pole. So how many slots are there? There are 48 slots are there. And number of pole is 4, so it is 12. The meaning is that for full pitch winding, we have to place the number of slot in such a that the slot number 1 will carries conductor 1, and slot number 12 should carries second conductor. Means this is the number of slots are there: 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So suppose this is the, your north pole is here and south pole is here. This is the south pole. So distance between these two will be the electrical degree is 180. So this is 180 degree electrical. The conductor is placed in slot number one. Is A1, and slot number 2 should be placed at 12th slot. This is your 12th slot. Then it will be a 180 degree or full pitch winding. But deliberately the second conductor is placed at 11th slot. So this is your 11th slot. So it is not a 180 degree. It is less than 180 degree, and this angle is equal to slot short pitch angle beta, as it is shifted by only one slot. So here it is beta is equal to alpha. Okay, so now we are going to calculate the pitch factor. So KP is equal to cos of beta by 2, and here it is a cos of 15 divided by 2. It is equal to 0.99. This is 0.99 is the pitch factor. So this is the very simple is there. Now we'll try to calculate one more numerical based on the same topics. So a three-phase 16-pole generator has a star connected. We will have a second numerical. In the second numerical, the data is given such that a three-phase alternator. So number of phases is equal to 3 and 16 poles, P is equal to 16. 16 poles, synchronous generator has star connected winding with 144 slots and 10 conductor per slots. So it is a star connected alternator is there. Okay. And the total number of slots, so number of slots is given is equal to 144 and 10 conductor per slot. We are placing how many conductors per slot? So it is a 10 conductors per slot. So we are taking 10 conductors per slot. The flux per pole is 0.03 Weber. So flux phi is equal to 0.03 Weber. Sinusoidally distributed and speed is 370 RPM. So speed of the alternator prime mover is 375 RPM. So it is quite clear that the speed of the prime mover is small, that is 375 RPM. Definitely it is this type of alternator or this type of turbine is going to use in the hydropower plants. And when the speed is smaller, the number of poles should be higher one. So see here, the number of pole is 16 and therefore the speed is small in such a way that we are able to produce the frequency is equal to 50 Hertz. Okay. Now calculate the frequency and line EMF. So we want to calculate here the frequency and line EMF. So it is line to line you are going to calculate. So again, I will repeat the sentence. A three-phase 16 pole synchronous generator has star connected armature winding with 144 slots and 10 conductor per slot. The flux per pole is 0.03 Weber, sinusoidally distributed and speed is 375 RPM. Calculate frequency and EMF. So we have a formula relation of synchronous speed is equal to 120F upon P, where P is the number of pole and if it's the frequency. So the frequency is generated. It is synchronous speed is here. It is given 375 multiplied by 16 poles are there. And it is divided by 120. It is equal to 50 Hertz. So here we have calculated the 50 Hertz. Now, second point we want to calculate EMF generated as it is a star connected. It is a star connected winding. So per phase multiplied by root 3, it is equal to the line voltage. So we want to calculate this voltage EL, line voltage over here. Okay. So first of all, we will calculate here. It is not given. It is a short pitch winding or shorted by somewhere, isn't it? So we can say that here the KP is equal to 1. KP is equal to 1. That is a full pitch winding. If it is given, then we have to calculate the pitch factor. Otherwise, it is a KP is equal to 1. And this is called as a full pitch winding. Next point, we are going to calculate the slot angle. So slot angle is equal to 360 degree mechanical over the periphery of armature divided by number of slots. It is 144. So it is equal to that is nothing but the mechanical angle. Now, this is how much it is? Just calculate it. So 360 divided by 144. So it is at 2.5 degree mechanical. Convert into the electrical angle. So P by 2 into mechanical angle. Mechanical angle, which is equal to 16 divided by 2 multiplied by 2.5 equals to 20 degree electrical. Okay, so now here the slot angle we have found out. Now what is the M? Number of slots per pole per phase. M is, what is that? Number of slots per pole per phase. So how many slots are there? How many slots are there? There are 144 slots. So it is 144 slots divided by poles, 16 poles, multiplied by 3 phase. So here M is equal to 3. So now we have the formula. What is the distribution factor? We will have a distribution factor Kp. Kp is equal to sine M alpha by 2 divided by M sine alpha by 2. So put these values. So sine M is equal to 3 multiplied by 20 divided by 2 divided by number of slot per pole per phase is 3 multiplied by sine 20 divided by 2. So it is equal to 0.96 is the distribution factor. So it is a KD distribution factor. This is the KD. Okay, so this is the your distribution factor we have found, isn't it? Now how many conductors are placed in a single slot? There are 10 conductors are placed or the single slots. So we can calculate the total conductors. So either we can calculate total conductor or turns per phase. So if you calculate turns per phase, what is the turns? Two conductor will make the one turn. Okay. So first of all, what we'll do? Okay, instead of this one, we will take one more step. First of all, we will calculate the number of conductor or TP. We will write as it is a TP. It is nothing but the turns per phase. Okay. So it is TP. TP is equal to total number of turns. So total number of conductors, we are going to calculate number of slots multiplied by conductor per slots. Conductors per slot. So you will get the total number of conductor. We want to calculate turns per phase. To make it turns, divided by 2. And per phase multiplied by 3, isn't it? So it is number of slots is 144. It is 144 multiplied by 10 conductors per slot divided by 2 multiplied by 3. So we get total turns per phase is 240. Okay. Now we have a formula per phase. It is the EPH is equal to 4.44 phi F or phi F KP KD TPH turns per phase. So it is 4.44 into 50 into 0.03 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 0.96 into 240. It is equal to 1534 volt, and therefore we are able to calculate line voltage E line, as it is a delta star connected, root 3 into 1534 equals to 2657 volt. So this is the EMF induced line to line. So this, by this way, we are able to find out this one. Now we will take one more numerical based on this same topic. A three phase 16 pole synchronous generator has resultant air gap flux 0.06 Weber per pole The flux is sinusoidally distributed. The stator has two slots per pole per phase and four conductor per slots are accommodated in two layers. The coil span is 150 electrical. Calculate the line and phase voltage when machine running at 375 RPM. So here the machine is running at 375 RPM. Definitely the number of pole will be higher one, isn't it? So here the number of pole, okay, here it is given that the number of pole is 16. So first of all, we will write whatever the given data is there. It is a three phase star connected, three phase star connected alternator is there. Okay, three phase star connected. And number of pole P is equal to 16 is given. Air gap flux phi is equal to 0.06 Weber per pole. The flux is sinusoidally distributed. The stator has two slots per pole per phase. Means here M is given. Number, it is two slots per pole per phase. So it is two, that is number of slots per pole per phase. It is given M, okay. And four conductor per slots. There are four conductors per slot. But here, total number of slot is not given. So first of all, we have to calculate the total number of slots. Then it is possible to calculate the slot angle. Any one more? Yes, it is. One more thing is given here. The coil span is 150 electrical. Here, the coil span is 150 degree electrical. Means it is a short pitch winding. The coil span is given, so it is a short pitch winding. So now we will calculate the angle beta, or short pitch angle. We are going to now hear from this solution. Okay, so data is over. So short pitch angle is equal to beta, which is equal to 180 degree minus this shorted span 150 degree electrical, and hence it is 30 degree electrical. Therefore, KP, pitch factor, is equal to cos of beta by 2. Cos of beta by 2. And it is equal to, if you put this value, we get it is 0.9659 is the pitch factor. Now, how many slots are there? M, what is given? Here M is given. What is that? Number of slots per pole per phase is equal to 2, isn't it? So if you multiply the number of phases and number of pole, you will get the number of slots. So therefore, number of slots is equal to M multiplied by phases multiplied by poles. So here it is 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 16. So here it is a 96 slots are there. Okay, so now from this one we can calculate the number of slot angle alpha is equal to 360 degree divided by 96 equals to how much? It is 3.75 degree mechanical, and therefore it is in electrical angle. So 16 divided by 2, where 16 is the number of pole, divided by 3.75 equals to it is a 30 degree 30 degree electrical. Now everything we know, we are able to calculate distribution factor. It is sine m alpha by 2 upon m sine alpha by 2. So after putting this value, we get 0.96599659 is the KD. Now, here the total number of slots we know, number of conductor per slots already given. So we are able to calculate turns per phase. So TPH is equal to number of slots, it is 96. Number of conductor per slot is 4 divided by 2. It will make the total number of conductor divided by 2. It will make the turns multiplied by 3 is the number of phases. So which is equal to 64. Therefore, line voltage, phase voltage EPH is equal to 4.44 50 hertz. Flux is 0.06. KP is equal to 0.9659 multiplied by 0.9659 into 64. And it comes 796 volt per phase. And here the line voltage V line is equal to 1377 volt. So in this way, we are able to calculate the EMF induced in the distributed winding. Now, one more example we can take on the same one. It is given that a 4-pole, 3-phase, 50 hertz, star-connected alternator has 60 slots with 2 conductor per slot and armature winding with 2 layers. Coil short pitch is in such a way that if one coil side lies in slot number 1 and the other lies in slot number 13, determine the useful flux. When the line voltage is 6000 volt. So here the number of pole P is equal to 4 and 3-phase 50 hertz. There is a number of slots. Number of slots is equal to 60 and 2 conductor per slots, 2 conductors per slot is given. And one more thing, it is a double layer winding. Okay, coil short pitch in such a way that it is placed, first conductor lies in the slot number 1 and the second conductor of the same coil lies in the slot number 13. Okay, so but we have to calculate the number of slots per pole. Okay, so first of all, we will calculate the number of slots per pole for the full pitch winding. So number of slots per pole, so which is equal to 60 divided by 4. So it is around, how much it is? It is 15. So the number of slot is equal to 50. So in such a way that your first conductor should lie in the slot number 1 and second should lie in the slot number 15. Then it is a full pitch winding. Okay, so first of all, we'll try to develop the diagram. Say this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So this is 13th slot, and this is slot number 1. One conductor is placed here, and the second conductor of same coil is placed here. So how many slot difference? It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we can say that the short pitch angle, so it is 12 multiplied by alpha. Okay, but first of all, we have to calculate alpha. So alpha is equal to 360 divided by 60 equals to, it is equal to 6 degree mechanical. Now alpha is equal to 6, it is a 4 divided by 2 multiplied by 6, so it is a 12 degree electrical. So what is the pitch angle? So pitch angle is equal to, there are 12 slots multiplied by 12 degree. So 144 degree electrical. Therefore, short pitch angle beta is equal to 180 minus 144, 180 minus 144, which is equal to 36 degree electrical, 36 degree electrical. So now we are able to calculate Kp is equal to cos of 36 divided by 2, which is equal to 0.951. So first part we have calculated, that is the, now second one, we want to calculate the distribution factor. So KD, so first we will calculate the M. What is the M? That is number of slots per pole per phase. So 60, number of pole is 4, number of phases is 3, so which is equal to 5. So here M is equal to 5. So distribution factor KD is equal to sine M alpha by 2 divided by M sine alpha by 2. And if you put these values, we get it is equal to 0.9567. Now tons per phase, TPH is equal to, how many slots are there? 60 slots, and each slot carries the 2 conductors. So 60 multiplied by 2 divided by 2. So it will become total conductor divided by 2. It become a tons per phase. So there are 3 phases are there. So we can calculate the tons per phase is equal to 20. Now what is given? It is given that at open circuit, the line voltage is given, EL is given 6000 volt. It is a line to line. It is line to line values. Okay. Now we want to calculate the flux. So if you put the values of this, all this parameter, we are able to calculate. So EPH is equal to 4.44 F5 Kp Kd into TPH. This is the per phase. As it is a line voltage, so we will convert into the phase voltage divided by root 3 equals to 4.44 into 50. Flux we want to calculate. multiplied by kp is equal to 0.951, kd is equal to 0.9567 into 20. Okay, so here the flux comes equal to 0.857 Weber per pole. So this is the some points, this is some numericals based on your distribution factor and pitch factor.